These are Section 8 vouchers, but the public housing communities go along roughly the same locations. And you'll see here that these vouchers are located in only a few areas that are very dark blue. They're located in lighter shades of blue, especially along this corridor. And we know the Hidden Valley and the east side. We know that the northwest, we know that the west side has a lot of Section 8 vouchers and public housing communities. Now, the city's locational policy is trying to handle this issue. We decided to tackle it in a different way through the livability index instead of making a comment about the nature of the community where it's fragile, it's stable. We're talking about housing in particular with community. So what you see is that there are a couple of issues. One you see in this little pod-shaped area right here, there are very few vouchers. That's South Charlotte, Southeast Charlotte, extending from Uptown, Myers Park, all the way down to, I hate to say this word, the Valentine neighborhood. So that's an area where you see substantial amounts of dark blue here and around here. But you don't see a lot of affordable housing. Now, why are these areas dark blue? If you look up here, where are the better schools? Where are the higher performing schools? Along the southeast ridge of the county and extreme northwest around the lake. When you look at employment opportunities, the darker areas here, you see uptown, there's spokes along I-77, going south, around Pineville and the Valentine area. You see the lighter areas where wealth is. Okay, you see where light rail is, and you see where transit and the bus lines are. But you see there's a lack of them in the area that we're talking about. Okay? Now, this is the issue. We have said that we want our communities and our voucher holders to be located in areas that have good schools, transit, employment opportunities, and access to all of these quality of life issues. But the problem is that if all the schools are located here, but very little of the transit is located there, it's going to be tough to say, I want to put a lot of affordable housing right here. Okay? So what I'm going to have to do is work with the city and the county to say, okay, I need for us to take public policy actions to put transit and other opportunities in this area so I can locate affordable housing here. I'm also going to have to say, I need to land, get the land a lot more affordable than it is right now. So I need you to help me subsidize the cost of the land. Now, when we look at this map, we believe, and I haven't discussed this with the board yet, but the staff believes that the area that is most conducive for affordable housing that is not there right now is really the south area right here. It's got its share of transit and light rail. It's a fairly hot employment area, and there are decent schools. Sorry about that.
You can't put that music on there.
Yes, he did. there are employment areas here, and we think that we can, we own some land in this area, and we can get access to land through the government, local government in this area. Now, I'm showing you this because it is one thing to talk about a locational policy, is one thing to talk about inequities in different parts of the city and the county, but it's another thing to confront the issue with facts. And what we decided to do was to be a little more scientific about this and state it in a positive way. We did the analysis that said, we'll give you a graphic depiction of everything that we've been talking about. what does the community look like when you want to talk about effective public schools? This is what it looks like. What does the community look like when we want to talk about employment value? And when you take all of those and layer them on top of each other, from an affordable housing standpoint, where is the greatest need for affordable housing in Charlotte-Mecklenburg? And it is this area. But in order for us to do this, we're going to need resources and we're going to need public policy to make it happen.